I've fallen, and I can't get up.
911?
This isn't really an emergency, but it is sort of one to this little old lady. I've been terribly upset, and I thought the only thing I could do, I don't think of sleep pills and all of that. I went out and bought myself a couple of small bottles of beer. I thought that would relax
me. What's the problem?
The problem is I can't open the bottle. Could you send a man over, and I'll be downstairs and have him open the bottle?
Okay, now, wait a minute. Am I correct that you can't sleep, so you went out and bought two bottles of beer, and you want a policeman to come by and open them for you?
Yes, please, because I don't have any equipment here that seems to handle that kind of a pop. And I have never gone in. I think I had a ketchup bottle once, and a neighbor broke the top off.
Oh, well, listen, I'm going to get you someone out there to open those beer bottles. Well, you just stay in your apartment now,
yeah.
And I'll send them up to the apartment. What's your phone number?
Wait till I take a look at it. It's a new one, and I don't remember it very well. Oh, the hell, I can hardly see it. It's all blotted and blurred. It looks like a... I can't see it with all the magnifying.
Okay, you can't see it without magnifying glass. That's okay that I don't know your phone number now.
Well, it looks like it. It has been put in by the operator, or the one that put the phone in, and it's down below, and that is was it, and then they put another one on the top, and it's sort of over blurred. I'm sorry about
that. That's okay. I'll just get it.
I'm cold sober, and
I know you are.
Yeah, and I don't have any bad intent or anything. I just want to be able to go to sleep.
I know. Well, we'll get you a unit out there to open that beer bottle.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Shall I hang up?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Happy, happy, joy, joy.
Hello.
Hi, this is the police. Don't hang up the phone, okay? Can you just stay on the phone with me?
Yeah, okay.
Are you home alone?
Yeah.
With just mommy?
I can't do it.
You can't unlock it?
No.
That's okay, honey. I'm going to get you some help, and they're going to unlock it for you, okay? You just keep talking to me till they get there.
Okay.
We're going to send somebody to open the door for you so your mommy can get out.
Okay.
How old are you?
I'm 4. Well, you're okay.
I'm okay. I can't get out.
Mom can't get out.
I'm not hurt.
My mom can't get out.
Okay, I know she can't get out. We've got some...
Tell them I can't. Mommy not hurt.
My mom says she can't open the door.
I know. She can't open the door, and you can't open the door, huh?
Yeah. You're okay, Mom.
I'm okay. The mommy's not hurt. I just check it out.
Just tell her you're talking to the police.
Mama's locked in.
I know she's locked in, huh? We're going to get her out.
Okay.
Will you go open the door for the policeman? He's right outside your front door.
Okay.
Tell mommy it's okay.
You can't open it.
I can't. The door is down. I can't get it open.
Okay. Do you care if I hit against it? Stand by. We should be able to get it open. Stand by.
George.
The door's unlocked on your side?
My mom said it. But she got for laughing.
Okay, good. Honey, you did a really, really good job. You call us again if you need help, okay?
Okay.
All right. Bye-bye, honey.
911.
Yes. What's his nose?
And I can't catch him.
Pardon me?
Ronald's dog is loose. Butchie. He told me to watch Butchie for him, and Butchie got away from me.
Well, where's Butchie going?
He's on his leash. Would you guys please help me find Butchie for Ronald beats my butt?
No, we can't. I'm sorry.
I was trying to find Ricky.
Well, we can't help you on something like that because we're the police department and we have to handle burglars and criminals. Sorry.
Gosh, Butchie's gone.
Well, you'll have to go find Butchie yourself or get somebody else to help you find Butchie.
Gosh, okay, thank you.
Okay, okay, bye.
Yes, she's coming 3 8 this close. Did she call before she's choking? She's waiting for an ambulance.
What happened
there? Anything out of the overhead surgery and I'm choking her. Something was...
What are you choking on, ma'am?
Will you get your ass over here? I'm choking to death.
What are you choking on, ma'am?
I'm choking in some kind of seeds that I swallowed last night.
Are you having any pain or anything from your throat?
Yes, I'm going up, but nothing comes out. I'm will you guys hurry up?
To my mother, there are just two kinds of food. First, there's the food she prepares herself.
Oh, I'm stuffed to the gills. I broiled a beautiful fillet of sole, and I had some of my jello mold that was so yummy. just made a tasty turkey roast sandwich. I steamed up some broccoli that was so tender, and I made a delicious squash casserole.
And here's what she had to say about food prepared by others.
They served corned beef that was so fatty. They served turkey that was too pink and raw. They served carrots that were drowning in butter and corn on the cob that got stuck in my denture. The mushroom soup was ugh, bleh. The liver tasted more like a pancreas. The meatball could choke a horse. The matzo ball could choke two horses and a goat. They gave us string beans that were hard as a rock. The most revolting candied yams and lox that was so salty I started to gag. Ooh, the muffin made me nauseous. The chow mein made me nauseous. The rice pudding made me nauseous. The layer cake made me nauseous. I ate the pumpkin pie and I thought I would throw up. Ugh. And their broccoli was so gassy, I was all fushdunkin. Excuse me. Pamela, I just want to ask you a quick question. When you go out at night, do you wear any particular kind of brassiere? Because a lady here says she read that there was a girl who was just standing outside her house when all of a sudden there was some kind of shooting, and apparently her life was saved because a bullet got lodged in her padded bra. So I'm thinking, if you're going to be walking around the city late at night, it couldn't hurt to go over to Macy's lingerie department and buy yourself what basically amounts to a bulletproof vest with built-in cleavage. All right, honey. Bye-bye.
I live in a building that has a doorman in the lobby, and my apartment has three locks on the door and a peephole. To my mother, this is still not secure enough.
Hi, Angela. I was just thinking, when that fellow knocks at your door and says that it's David, how do you know it's really him and not some sugarna? So before you go letting him in, you ought to ask him to bend under the door and slide you a photo ID. Give me a call. Bye-bye.
Through the years, my mother's dropped some pretty strong hints that she'd like me to meet someone from a similar background.
Hi, Amala. I don't know if you have any plans yet for Christmas Eve, but apparently I hear that all of the single Jewish guys in New York go to a big party that night called the Matzah Ball. Did you ever hear of such a thing?
Sometimes her rationales are a little far-fetched.
A home where there's a mixed marriage is not necessarily all hunky-dory, because when the holidays come, the candles on the menorah could ignite the Christmas tree.
Now, I sometimes wonder what would happen if my mother thought I was serious with someone who wasn't Jewish. So I tried an experiment, and one day, when she dialed my number, she heard,
"Hi, this is Amy.
And this is Jamal.
We can't come to the phone right now, but leave a message after the tone.
Holla back."
Hello? Hello? Amy, are you there? Hello? Amy? I think you have a crosswire because your message is playing over the outgoing message from some other line. There's a male voice that's overlapping, and it sounds like you're doing a duet. If you can hear me, call 611 Repair and have them straighten it out ASAP.
Then, like 2 seconds later, she calls again.
Yeah, this message is for Jamal. If you can hear this, please call your repair service ASAP because your outgoing message is coming over my daughter's machine. So anyone calling you will also hear the message from someone named Amy. Thank you. Hi, Amala. I hope you made it to the airport with everything intact. you know, I'm not thrilled with you carrying your keys and wallets and your plane ticket behind you in a backpack where anyone can reach in and take it. If women were meant to carry valuables behind them, then how come no woman ever spent 9 months carrying a baby in her tuchus? All right? I'm hoping you'll come to your senses and at least buy a tote bag. Okay, Mama Shanks, let me hear from you. Hi, Amala. I don't know if you saw 60 Minutes, but they did a report that said the electric eyes on the elevator doors have a very high rate of malfunctioning. So don't go putting your hand in the door just as it's going to close, or you'll end up with a sticker for handicapped parking. All right, sweetie, I'll talk to you later.
Mom, are you listening? I love you. Bye.